You're not really responsible for what one madman is doing, but at the same time, you have to make a choice between what's easy and what's right. My name is Elizabeth Larina. We were born and raised in Russia, so basically it's my homeland.
My name is Eugene Liapin. I was a political activist in Russia. I was LGBTQ plus rights activist in Russia, and now we live in Wellington.
We knew we were living in quite unstable environment in Russia, but never ever we expected that Russia will actually start like a real war. We watched this announcement from Russian president. He like announced that we're going to start a military operation.
Of course, Putin is a military guy, but till the very end, nobody, I would say nobody in Russia ever believed that he is mad at this level to invade Ukraine.
I feel so bad for people who actually live in Ukraine at the moment and they have to hide in the metro and they can't live in their houses because it's just not safe for them. And I can't even imagine how is it to find a dead body when you're just walking down the street.
This country will never be the same. In Russia we have such level of propaganda. Unfortunately, I would say that quite a lot of people believe in that, because it's really hard to accept that your country is invaders. And now they introduced new legislation which can send you to the prison just if you even call this war a war. A lot of Russians who understand what's going on, they may be afraid to openly speak up about the situation and oppose this aggression.
Worst case scenario, if Ukrainians are fighting this evil by themselves, they might just fall. And definitely Putin will not stop there. It's a violation of all the human and political agreements that are being made.
The thing is, if you even stop this war, but Putin still will be the president of Russia, it will be infinite threat. It will be the end of the Russia and maybe even the world. As I said, it's hard to accept that your country, it's all turned into the second incarnation of Hitler's Reich.
I hope that Ukrainian people who live in New Zealand and all over the world, they will perceive this as war of one person. We've never been aggressive to Ukrainian people, and we will never be, because they're our relatives, they're our friends. We are brothers at the end of the day.
And we have common enemy, this enemy called Vladimir Putin.